Today, I've got three things to talk about. .NET 10 Preview 3 is out. I'm going to actually write some code. I'm going to write some C# code. My God, it's actually happening. Some MCP updates for Semantic Kernel, and some poor Redditor is crying into his coffee about should he still use MVC? We will answer that question. So, C# 14 in Preview 3 has added a little something called extension methods. All right, so imagine this code that you can see down there, yeah? We've got a list here, Gary, Nigel, and Barry, okay? And we've written an extension method called contains Gary, pretty simple. This is existing code that works today in C# versions and has for a very long time. So obviously it just finds the name Gary in that list. And if we run it, it will say true down here. Down the bottom left there. So now when you submit this for your pull request next year and your architect goes, oh, maybe that should be a property, not a method. And you say, well, I can't add properties to lists, can I, Mr. Architect? Well, now you can. And this is what they're going to do. So we can delete all of this stuff. And they have actually now added yet another keyword. And arguably, the design here, whilst adds more C# syntax, and in reality, C# has enough syntax, yeah? I mean, they add new stuff every year. It's got the word extension in it instead of this, so it's arguably better language design. So we're going to do a property here instead of that method. So we're going to actually have a property called contains Gary, like this. And because it's a property, it has a getter, and we can do return source.any name. We'll just do it this way for now. Name is Gary, like this, right? And now this is actually a property instead of a method. We can delete that and run a wrap again, like so. And it will say true. And obviously, if we remove Gary by adding Gary 2, it's now false. Extension methods. And bear in mind that .NET 10 is super important. It's an LTS release, so everyone's going to upgrade. We get null conditional assignments. Okay. If customer is not null, you don't actually have to write this anymore. You can just do a little question mark like this. More syntax, more variants in C# when the world is becoming big fans of the Go language, which is simple. See, I've even got the hoodie on. Yeah, is this necessary? I'll leave it up to the viewer to decide. They've also finally added validation support in minimal APIs. Okay, so MVC has had built-in pipeline level validation support for as long as I've been doing .NET. So since the very beginning of .NET MVC, you could do model.isValid in your controller method, and assuming you have your data attributes set up correctly, it's all good. Now you can do this and create validators in the root here. Cool. Well done, minimal APIs, for catching up when you could do this in MVC for a very, very long time. Hopefully you didn't spend too much time waiting for this, but this is quite an important topic. So. I will then touch on this at the end of the video on the MVC question. Semantic Kernel is a thing, one of the many AI libraries that is coming out of Microsoft. I think it's a slightly different team from the .NET team. And there must be some like turf war going on. But anyway, they've added MCP support for Python because all anybody is talking about in AI tech bro world is MCP. MCP is a wrapper around tool calling, essentially creating a standard so that your LLM can discover it, although it's probably represented by some text underneath anyway. So they've added MCP support to the Python version of Semantic Kernel. This is pretty cool. They've also added Google A2A protocol to Python. Now, when I first saw this news, I got a little bit grumpy as usual, and I did control F .NET, and I could only find a reference to .NET in the header. And I'm thinking, did they actually do Python first. I wouldn't put it past them. They don't mention C sharp anywhere in this blog post. Actually, they did it in March, so a month ago, added MCP, both sides of this, to Semantic Kernel. So Semantic Kernel is, this is my educated guess, is this is what they use to power Copilot under the hood. And they've released all of the code to be able to serve MCP servers and call them as well in C sharp, and they can map, use this MCP client factory to create functions and add them to the Semantic Kernel builder. I'm going to try this in a video soon. I do have some AI videos on this low effort channel, so if you'd like to see them come up, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll do some MCP in C sharp if enough people subscribe at this point in the video. I'll be able to tell. So yeah, that's great. Python is now second class citizen in the Semantic Kernel world, so thank you, Microsoft, I don't say this often, for putting C sharp first for a change. Next up, a trip to r.net, which is where people give each other therapy in the use of .NET. On Reddit, ASP.NET MVC still relevant? I do mostly Blazor for in-house apps. In-house, that's the word again. Now I bought the book Real World Web Development with .NET 9 to broaden my horizon in web development. Poor guy started with Blazor first, so okay. The book is mostly about MVC. Funny that, it's called Real World. I wonder if that technology is still considered for new projects. There are CMS and online shop frameworks that are built on top of that. Yes, there are. But is the pure ASP.NET MVC used? It seems to me to be much less productive than Blazor nowadays. Well, that depends what you mean by productive, sir. If you want to drag and drop some stuff onto the screen one day when they actually make the drag and drop editor work again, then yeah, it's might be in the short term more productive. The MVC is not going anywhere, as these commenters will say. Yeah, MVC is still used. A lot of business apps use it, both legacy apps and new developments. My job is largely MVC based. See, the dirty secret out there is that MVC is everywhere. It has been around for 10 years and is actually still now really, really good. If you want to write an API, you can use it. If you want to write server-side rendered pages, you can use it. If you want to use HTMX, and you know the world's gone full circle and now we like server-side rendering, use it. It's better than doing JavaScript on the server, guys. Yeah. What advice is this poor guy getting? So if you want to do server-side rendering, have lightweight and fast websites, stuff like that, it's a good option. Razor Pages. My problem with Razor Pages is that it's a set of there's nothing transferable. Okay. If you do MVC, you can go and do Ruby on Rails. If you do MVC, you can go and use Spring in Java. If you do Razor Pages, well, you can go back to web forms. Okay, very good. Nothing wrong with MVC. This is correct. MVC with HTMX calling for partial views. Great combo. I want to do some HTMX and MVC on this channel. If you think that's a good idea, leave a comment. And I do read them all, by the way. It even brightens up my day sometimes. I primarily use Blazor or Razor Pages. Haven't made an MVC app in some time. I still maintain a crap load of MVC apps. So yay, tons of jQuery. jQuery's okay. Yeah, exactly. I never understood the hate jQuery gets, said this chap. There, my favorite design pattern. See, look at these guys. Don't be shamed. Don't feel shame in liking MVC, okay? A lot of people say, Blazor, Razor Pages, it's a new hotness. MVC, it's good. It's very good. Maybe too good. Maybe too good. It means that the poor guys on the team that want to ship a new framework don't get the traction they need. ASP Core MVC still works well. Yeah. Server-side rendering is still the best choice for a lot of non-interactive CMS powered corporate or brochure web websites. Yes, it is. If you're trying to make Google Maps, don't use MVC. Okay? Have an SPA and a backend. You can still use MVC for your API calls, but you need a front end as a singular SPA. And this is where people use Blazor Server and get themselves in a in a tiz there, or Blazor Hybrid even, and mix the world of client and server, and I'm not in that. I can't do that anymore. We've seen it go wrong too many times. What's old is new again. Stick around long enough and you'll see this many times in your career. Yes, we have gone full cycle back to server-side rendering. Thank you for watching. If you don't want to hear me yap, you can go to my website, which is linked below, and subscribe to my newsletter. Very early days, but I might even actually write something for a change. And blog, like 2014. Do you remember blogging? Does anyone remember blogging? If you found that at all entertaining, please leave a like. And if you don't subscribe, please consider it. It makes me a happy camper. Thank you for watching.